You need to leave your house.
You will never change.
Dwell among us. Let your glory never pass us by. Do that which only you can do. Pass through me and speak your word. Use me and bless your people. And all the men and women under the sound of my voice, today their life will never remain the same. Father, have your way. Let your name alone be glorified. Jesus, mighty name, I pray. Shout a name like a believer. Have your seats in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to use this opportunity to welcome our viewers all over the world. You are watching Holy Covenant Adoration Church International. We are transmitting from Padova, Italy. I want to celebrate the friends, the visitors, the sons and daughters of Holy Covenant. This last Sunday in this month of June, we do you good in Jesus' name. You must have a testimony that will make people ask you, where did you go? If you believe it, your amen is supposed to be louder than that. If you are not a suspect, shout a bigger amen. I want to tell you, if a man of God shout and pray, if your amen did not sound, you will not receive. Amen means so be it. And when you are looking like you are watching film or home video, that blessing will not come until you connect with amen. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. Open your Bible with me in the book of Psalm 144. Psalm 144. I read it from verses 3 down to 4. Psalm 144. Amen. Psalm 144. From 3, the word of God said, Lord, what is man that thou takest knowledge of him? Or the son of man that thou makest account of him? Man is like a vanity. His days as a shadow that passeth away. Man
is like a breeze. Man is like a flower that can blossom in the morning, but in the evening when the sun shines, the rose flower begins to quench and die. Beloved brethren, I want to preach a little bit. This is a title. You are a tenant. Tell somebody, you are a tenant. I want you to touch your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, you are a tenant. Touch that neighbor. Same neighbor. You are a tenant. I said, touch the neighbor. Tell that neighbor. Neighbor. You are a tenant. Hallelujah, somebody. I don't know the person that will be offended through this message. I don't know the person that will be offended because of this preaching this morning. But this message is for you. You did not plan to hear it, but God planned to tell you that on this planet, hey, you are dwelling, you are a tenant, beloved brethren. We all are tenants on this earth. We all are tenants in this land. We came from somewhere and we are going to somewhere. When the original landlord will give a quick notice, your position, your money, your title, your company, your resources, your attire, your beauty, your handsome, your legacy cannot stop you. When the original landlord of heavens and the earth will give big notice, nothing can save man from leaving this planet earth to where he is going. Beloved brethren, we are on transit. I want this message to sink inside your mind and your head and your medulla oblongata that we are tenants on the earth. It doesn't matter how many flats you build. It doesn't matter how many estates you have. It doesn't matter how many cars you park in your garage. It doesn't matter how many containers you have in the sea that's moving to Africa or any part of the world. It doesn't matter how many wardrobes that you have that filled up with markers. But I want to tell you, there is one spirit, one angel that I call obedient servant of God. There is one angel. He's a spirit. He's an angel. I call him obedient servant of God. His name is Death. His name is called what? Death. Death is obedient servant of God. That angel come and invite you. Your escort, your security, your bulletproof car cannot protect you. Your wire cost you use to surrender your duplex or your mansion cannot surrender you. When the spirit, the angel that is a messenger of the Most High, I call him obedient servant of God. No medication, no medical doctor can protect you. No prophet, no prophecy can save you. Because even that prophet, even that bishop, that archbishop has his day to leave the earth. Mr. Death, anytime he knocks at your door, he doesn't put protection for him. He doesn't preach gospel for him. You cannot sow seed to him. You cannot pay tithe to him. You cannot bribe him. If life can be purchased with money, no man or woman under the sound of my voice can buy life. There are people that could have purchased it and stored it in their warehouse. President, they spend years in the office. You call them ex-president. Ex-president. bishop, let archbishop, let pope, let prophets, beloved brethren, I wanted you to think, one day your name in that office will be X. Your name on this planet Earth will be late. Nothing can stop it. If not X in that office, if not X in that job, if not X in that business, it will be late on this Earth. It will be late in your father's house. It will be late in your mother's house. It will be late in the society. Tell your neighbor, never. Touch that neighbor, say never. You are a dust. Say never. You are a dust. I can't hear you touching to somebody. I can't hear you touching somebody. Say never. You are a dust. Say never. Look at me. You are a dust. Sand, the dust of the earth. Dust we are made with, to dust we are returning. Any plan you are planning, any arrangement you are making, any occasion you are planning, the blessing of marriage of today, they started planning it for months ago. The dedication of goodness, they started dedication planning it and preparing it for months ago. Who is ready preparing and planning for his death? Who is ready planning and preparing for his death? It must come. Whatever you are doing, beloved brethren, begin to prepare. One day, you will be late. A second, you will be late. A minute, you will be late. A day, you will be late. In a week, inside a month, inside a year, you will be late. If you don't have it in your mind, you will not caution yourself. If you don't have it in your mind, you will not counsel yourself. If you don't have it in your mind, you will not plan well that you are on transit. Of a whole me. Do you know who I am? Do you know what I am up to? You are a dust. You are a dust. Beloved brother, don't kill yourself to make the whole money on the earth. Don't kill yourself to marry the most worthy man. Don't kill yourself to build the highest skyscraper. Don't shed blood to ride the best jeep. Don't shed blood to receive the highest title in your community. If I may ask you, what is the untold story behind your marriage? What is the untold story, the hidden story, the secret story behind your marriage? Where did you go? Where went you to get that man in your life? Where did you go to get that woman in your life? What did you do to keep him for yourself? What did you do to keep her for yourself? The unknown story may be hidden before men, but it's not hidden before God. What is the untold story before your world? What is the untold story, unknown story behind your money? What have you done to make it?
That house you build, what have you done to build it? Beloved brethren, all are vanity. My father is no longer seeing his house again. My mother is not seeing the house she built with her husband again. Let me tell you somebody, before I came out to the pulpit, the first man came and preached in a Sunday school and he quit. The second man came and coordinated and he quit. The third person came with praises, she quit. The second person came with worship and she quit. Now I have come to preach the gospel, I will also quit. I want to let you know, brethren, on this earth you must quit. You will not be there forever. You will not be there forever. I'm telling you what I know. On Thursday, when I was in a program in Ireland, I want to tell you something, things that happened on this earth. In the course of the prayer line of deliverance, a young lady, in the name of dragging a husband or dragging a fiancé, you are not husband yet, dragging a boyfriend, they are not fiancé, they are calling it a boyfriend. In the name of dragging a boyfriend, she ran to Nigeria because she had found that two other girls have succeeded in taking the boy from her. She went to a good state to make the man's manhood to die. She ran to a good state to make the man's manhood to die. The thing is, God unfortunately said, okay, if as you pursue me, carry this one. Okay, come and do now. Let I see. What is the secret, untold story behind your bitch? What is the untold story behind your success? Are you a minister, man of God, watching me? What is the untold story behind your ministry, your altar, your calling, the power you are using to pray? Where and where have you gone to get what you have? What and what have you done to reach where you are? My name is Prophet Chusu Obatobi. I speak with boldness. I know my God. The young girl, even the young man has said that they are dragging, no girl head. Even the young man that we are dragging, no girl head. Thank God for the deliverance that night. The girl has said that fighting with the other one as with the boy. In the time of her own deliverance, the boy ran away. Because the manifestation of that girl became something else. There are things you do not fight for. The blessing of the Lord make it rich and add them no sorrow. Don't fight for it. If it is yours, it must surely come. Blessed is the man
that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of the sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Two said, but his delight will be what? His delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. Hold on the Lord. What gonna be will be. They will not say that one. In the time of testimony, they will not say everything. What is the untold story? How your baby came? You tell us God has blessed you. This is your baby. What happened? Where did the man of God took you to? Which river did he bath you? Which concoction did you drink? They will not say it in the time of testimony. They will carry baby, come show us. There is untold testimony. There is untold story. Beloved brethren, we are tenants. You have no right to beat me on the head. I have no right to beat you on the head. It's only the landlord of the landlords. It's only the landlord of the landlords. You that are killing, shedding blood, looking for who to kill. Did you remember that you are a tenant? You assassin, you are paying money to assassin somebody. Do you remember you are a tenant? A tenant want to quit a tenant. Do you know the debts that the landlord will give to you? Thursday night. Get me my phone. That white one on top. Thursday night, about what time? I was there when I was in program. One pastor, I don't know him, but he's a friend of Holy Covenant on Facebook. He wrote me, yeah, that was Thursday night, this 2 or 3 days ago, yeah, Thursday. From Milan. He wrote, I don't know him, I haven't seen him before, one on one, we haven't spoken, but he dropped a message for me. I came to my hotel room to rest after afternoon service, waiting for the evening one. As I came to rest, I saw a message that came in through Holy Covenant messenger. I read the message. He said, my prophet, we don't know, but I got a revelation. God spoke to me concerning you last week, and God sent the message to tell you, but I did not pass the message. Because I'm afraid, I don't know how you will react. Because we don't know, we haven't spoken before. This man is in Milan. He's one of these men of God that used to do live program on Facebook. I used to see his page, his program on Facebook. He used to do night program, you people know him. So, he said I should pray that he got the revelation and he didn't deliver the message. But the Lord had been flogging him that if he refused to deliver the message, that he, the God that gave him the ministry, will take it from him. So he said he was sleepless night and restless. And he wrote me. I read him. I said, sir, can I call you? He said, yes. I called him through Facebook call, but I don't have his number. I said, is Prophet online? You drop a message for me, what's happened? Praise the Lord. This man never come to Padova, never know me, we don't know. He told me, he said, my prophet, the Lord said I should tell you that there are assassins. Let me tell you, one of the sisters called me last week and gave me the dream. One of the sisters called me and gave me the dream. Exactly. He said, there are assassins that have planned to kill themselves, not me. He said, listen, he said that they will work with members of the church to get me. If I lie, my Lord see good thing this one. That the members of my ministry are their agents. That the pastors in this land said they must take my life away. That they have tried through charm, through Kitu, I didn't die. You know, last time they break egg here. I don't know what that one means, really rich me. One Tuesday after service, they drop one charm. Actually, I'm one that I told to throw it at the main road. They drop one charm there, throw it at the main road. The other day, they kill pigeon. It's a mess, I think. They kill pigeon there. I don't know what it means. They are dominating. They even pursue me before your wedding, April. Hallelujah. All those things, you know, they reach me. Now, they have gone to hire assassin. I want to tell you, if you are here, be not be killed by a man. No man can kill me except the number of the landlords. My name is Prophet Joshua of Atobia. Them more. They say they are blocking their ways. If you want, I will give you the pastor drop his number. I told him I'm going to pray. He said, tell the members that the Lord said. Hallelujah. They tell us the pastors in Padova, I don't know the church you came from. Listen to me. Tell your pastor that Prophet Joseph cannot be killed by a man. They said I'm blocking their ways. Let them live charm. Let them live to truth. Let them worship only God. I'm not afraid of any bastard. I cannot fear him. I fear only God. This message has been coming and coming since. Message that be coming. Last time it was this my daughter Sophia that had a dream and called me. It was last month. That's my thing. She had a dream, she called me. She told me. Now a man of God in Milan has called. He said I should tell the church that it's them that the enemy will use. For you, if you connect with them, no problem. They remember you're a tenant. Tenants cannot quit a tenant. Tenants cannot quit a tenant. We have only one landlord. It's all but two. If I'm blocking their ways, let them change their ways. If I'm destroying the thing they are using, let them change their ways. I don't know the source of their ministry. Only God knows. You are the members in this church.
I never mentioned any pastor's name. I pray to God. And the God that knoweth who is doing whatever they are doing.
I don't know who you communicate with.
If you speak with your language, I will not hear. But God hears all languages.
They remember there is I that see the secret. We are tenants. We all are tenants. I am a tenant, brother. You are a tenant. But there is something you need to know. In the book of Psalm 91, he said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I shall say of the Lord, he is my refuge, my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. 1,000 shall fall by my side, 10,000 as my right hand. He shall not touch me. With my eyes shall I behold and see the reward of the wicked. Stand on your feet.
You are the only one. There is no.
God said, we are dust. We are men with dust. Everything we have now, we are leaving them. The most painful thing